Hi everyone, welcome to this beautiful Finnish landscape. This is the space of the Vocational College, and I'm here with folks from the school. Would you like to introduce yourselves?
Yes, thank you. Hi, I'm Jukka Seppänen and I am an e-learning specialist at Voke. My job involves learning about new technologies and then teaching that information to our staff and to myself. I'm learning a lot about building the world, and this is one of my, basically my practice project that we have been using as an example. And with me there's Toni Mikkonen and Katja Huttunen.
My name is Mikkonen and I work as an instructor of future technologies here at Voke.
Hello, and my name is Katja Huttunen. And I'm a coordinator of technological education for practical nurses and youth workers and kind of social studies that we have here. And using VR and other game-based learning.
Can you tell me something fun about your team?
The biggest thing is maybe that we are all gamers and we all like to play games. So that's kind of big thing that we got our jobs, and we actually all have been students for Pocket beforehand, and now we are like working here. So yeah, we stuck here now.
So let's talk a little bit about how you have started your own journeys with XR, and we can start with you.
Yeah, me. My journey is very personal, really, that I was unemployed for a long time, and I've always been interested in technology, and I have always played games, and I just slowly, when I first tried VR, I basically got really interested, and I saw the potential, and I basically started learning from scratch. I have no experience at all, so my whole life changed around that I started building stuff and learning stuff, and I'm really happy that I'm able to create spaces like this, and it's just been a very, very, very important thing for me, and I got my job for it, and basically all our my whole team is like my friends, and Katja is my girlfriend, and so this is a really big part of my life. And yeah,
that's like how I started. I started dating with Jukka, and Jukka was like awesome and making like 3D art and stuff. He has like his own art gallery here also, and he make like super cool 3D printing stuff. So yeah, that's how I started, and now I'm learning how to make my own worlds and stuff like that. But if Jukka was not telling me how to do it, I wouldn't probably get it. But yeah, he's been like really big support. And we were actually, with Tony and I, we were doing this future technological course that he's actually teaching now. It was our first thing that our school kind of created, because we are doing so much stuff. So it was like easy way to show our knowledge that we are doing this course. And because we were so good at it, we are now working here.
Would you like to tell me a bit about the projects that you have personally done? So not with this school, but your personal projects with XR?
Well, I have quite a lot of... I think everything I do is about learning something new. So I don't think I have finished anything, but I'm just starting new projects to learn new stuff. Like, for example, in this world, you cannot see here, but there's water all around, and I learned how to do that from scratch, and it's stuff like that I like to, and also I do a lot of 3D modeling, and of course you need 3D modeling in XR on all different platforms. You need for AR, VR. That's the key to everything, I find. So I use most of my free time 3D modeling. That's one of the That's the biggest thing for me.
Could you tell me about this awesome space that you have built for Poke?
Yeah. This was a bit of I think this was the first one I started doing as like a basically for practice. I had not used Unity before to build anything, so it was a challenge. But the first idea was to, as you can see, there's a forestry machinery around us. It was part of that. I mean, the whole XR thing at Poke started with the forestry. So we started with the simulators. We still use them in daily education. We have I think we have 5 simulators or more. I lost count at this point, but we use them to we've used them in practice for a couple of years now already. So it's really a normal thing here. It's not like a future thing, but it's the modern day. This base was first to show what we have at our bioeconomy institute. So forestry is one. We have cows, the sheep there. We have tractors, and well, we are in the nature. That's one of the things. Big things we part of our education, and like nature trekking is actually one thing we teach. Yeah, so we can do that virtually too.
And can you tell the audience about the school and what you do here?
Yeah, so we are a vocational college, so we teach lots of different areas, and like we have forestry, like you can see, and we have healthcare, we have Katja knows healthcare, and logistics, metalworking, woodworking, building, about everything. So we are very, very, it's a bit of a challenge with the XR too, that we try to think of ways to utilize XR for all of these different areas. So forestry has been like, it's the prime example still, because it's what we use in practice, and it goes well with machinery and expensive machines and stuff like that. So I think as a school, we are very very open to new technology, and I really like that.
Yeah, and we're always starting new courses about different subjects. Like now we are starting to do healthcare, and we have like really big partner to do it with. Mehilainen, who is like really big Finnish healthcare provider. So there's like people who work Mehilainen, and they are in one of our courses that I'm teaching them, or we have like multiple teachers, but I'm like the technological advisor on those ones. And yeah, we are using VR stuff there. We are using 360 picture taking.
Yeah, like Katja mentioned, we also offer education, like courses and stuff for like outside of our. I mean, we are a vocational college. We also offer courses, so anyone can join and come to learn. Like Tony here teaches the future technologies. It's been very popular, and we have all kinds of people been in that course. Like we have unemployed people there, and we have also like. Doctor level people there, so it's a really wide range of different kind of people we have been able to educate.
So if anyone out there thinks about taking one of these courses, then you can maybe come here and talk to these people.
Yeah.
Ask about the courses. And can you tell me about the cool stuff that your school has done? What projects have you been working on?
I think I can show you one that we are basically standing into. So we have a bit of a partnership with Ponce and Valtra, and then we have this local smaller company called Moisio Forest, and we have their equipment here. Here we did this as a collaboration project, and this is a part of it. This is not the whole project, but it's a part of the things we are able to use. So we have their technical models, and we can use this in our education, and company benefits from it in marketing. So one of the first projects we did for this company was a virtual showroom of all of their equipment. Yeah, and so you could take this in VR and go to, they went to, they had an exhibition in France. And of course, you cannot take a heavy equipment like this, especially a small company. You cannot just take everything with you and go to France. So we did one VR headset, one laptop, and we had everything there. And it was really interesting because no one else had anything like it back then. And people were really impressed, and they got really different experience when they could actually see the machines like this. This is just a couple of examples from there, but the same principle goes here. Like I can tell you about this machine, and I can open it, and I could tell you how to put it together and stuff like that. It's really been one of my favorite things to do in VR, and I find it really useful.
I guess you can use this machinery to safely teach the students about these expensive big machines.
Yes, exactly. So we have the safety, of course, the physical safety. So you have dangerous equipment like this pneumatic equipment with sharp blades and stuff. And I can safely open it like this so we can see inside. And it's much easier, it's cheaper, it's safer.
So why is Poke working with XR technologies?
I think it's because we are very open-minded about new technology, and we are, I don't really know why, but I think it's just been proven to be useful and proven to be working. So we started with the simulators, and we are expanding, because with the simulators it's been, it just works, basically. We have seen the benefits, and we know that it's worthwhile, and we want to learn new stuff.
Yeah, and I think big part of it is that we have had like really free hands to try new stuff. Just like if like our own budget because of like a certain project, so we have money from that.
We had one of our products is future technologies course, and we offer that to our own students and to outside of our school too. We have had students with very, very different backgrounds. We have unemployed people, we have had professors, we have very high educated people to join us and learn about the new technology, because it's new for everyone. And that's been really interesting. And all of this, I think we have trained about 150 people so far with that. And it's still ongoing, and it's something that also that we are located in the central Finland, but it's not been a problem. We had people all around Finland, and we have people from Helsinki, and we have people from Lapland. So it's not a problem. It's lots of the stuff you can do remotely, so it works well. And the unit that inside Poke, we have the Poke DigiLab, and that's our own unit, and we have very free hands with our curriculum. We can do all kinds of we have our own budget, we have our own IT support, we do that ourselves. So we have had very free hands, and it really helps. And I can tell you that it helps, and that we can we have our own computers, we are kind of independent, but we offer the service to of course to all of our staff, and we work closely together with all. We are not that separate, but we still have our own unit, basically.
So what do you think is the best thing about working with XR?
I think one of the best things is the social aspect of it all. I still remember the first time I met someone in VR, I think it was from someone from United States, and I was working on one of these forestry machines in another environment, where you can move it and interact with it. And I think it was just an open environment, and then someone came to talk to me about it. And he was like, "Wow, what are you working on that like this?" And then he started telling me "Hey, you can put better texture here. You can make this glass better. You can put the lights on like this." And he was doing it in VR. I was watching it, and at the end, he minimized the machine, gave it to me, put it in your pocket, you can save it like that. I think that was one of the first mind-blowing experiences, that you can actually work with people that easily. You can do stuff you cannot imagine in real life, and you can, and I think that experience has really imprinted in me, and I think I've been chasing doing stuff like that since. I teach other people like that now, and it's also one of my favorite things to teach others how to do content, VR and XR content. That if I can teach someone to make a 3D model, and I see the 3D model in VR, it's really a good experience.
What do you think is one of the biggest challenges?
I think people have lots of preconceptions about VR, and they don't really like to use like headsets. They feel like it isolates them from the real world. And I think this is very one of the biggest challenges. What is the first experience you offer to people? It needs to be something that they can engage with. And I think social aspect is very, very one of the biggest ones, that you don't feel so isolated because you have people here. And if you just try it with open mind, you can see the benefits of it. And it's not that scary. Of course, there's lots of problems like the nausea and stuff like that that are still yet to be really solved. But a lot of those things you get used to, and they are not dangerous per se, unless you have some medical condition. It's just it just feels bad at the start, but it's not like dangerous to you.
You could collaborate with anyone in the world. Who would you want to collaborate with on a project?
Well, on a personal level, as a gamer, I would probably like to work with some of the big gaming companies and maybe work with like in VR versions of their games, for example. And it's still a new area that, of course, there are big companies like Valve who has made amazing stuff. So, of course, I would like to learn from them.
And how about a dream project? Do you have anything that you dream of doing in the virtual world?
Well, as my hobby is 3D modeling, I do lots of 3D models for 3D printing, and I think one of my dreams, and it's I've been like pivoting towards it, that I'm learning to do the models in for XR instead.
How do you see the future of this industry, and especially perhaps in education?
I see it as a very important tool for education. So I don't think that all education should be in VR or are going to be, but lots of it can be. And I think lots of it should be, because some things you can just do better and safer, cheaper. You can save the environment, you can reduce the carbon footprint. You don't have to travel long distances necessarily. You can do remote training. I think like Ponce and these companies we have worked with do that a lot. They already do it, but I think VR would be even better tool for that than just like a video call, and of course AR too. You can do remote assistance.
So why should MatchXR visitors visit this awesome space in particular?
We have lots of interesting stuff that you probably don't see anywhere else. We have cows and sheep here. We have really cool tractors and mechanical stuff. We have sauna and kind of value fire camp area that you can just chill and talk with each other. And yeah, we have like really cool different kind of art here. We have like hot air balloon that you can go check out. So yeah, I think we have like most diverse area.
So where can we find Poke Vocational College on the internet?
Yeah, well, our website is poke.fi, and it's our main website, and you can find our like on XR stuff from our DigiLab Instagram account, for example.
Well, thank you so much for having me here in your awesome space and showing me around, and I hope the audience will also get an opportunity to visit this world and see what it has to offer. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us. And see us here. Bye.